about 5 minutes to melt the lead. And that's a 45-pound pot, so about 30 pounds of lead in the pot. I'm going to be using two molds. One is for a semi-wad cutter, 38, and that throws 6 at a time. And then this one is a full wad cutter, and it throws 2 at a time. This is flux. I'm going to be using this next. That mixes the tin and antimony and lead together, and also cleans out all the dirt. There won't be much dirt in this. And that's the electric pot that I use to pour the molten lead into the molds. When they come out of the molds, they'll go in these buckets of water. So lead quenches, and it'll increase from a Brunel hardness of about 5 to maybe around 15. So this is flux material. There's a little bit of dirt in it, but mainly this makes the alloy go back into solution. It's actually a white powder, and you'll see when I skim off the dross, the dirt, the lead will be almost as shiny as a mirror. This is the material that I used to flux, Frankfurt Arsenal. And this is what's left over on that log. So that's a good after shot. All of the alloying material was back in solution. So I've transferred from the big pot to my small electric pot. This pot holds 10 pounds. You can do it another way. You can drop ingots into this pot. You just have to flux the pot. I don't like to do that because it makes the pot real dirty.
So I've been casting for about 10 minutes. As you can see, it goes through the lid pretty quickly. One thing you've got to watch out for is if water splashes up in the mold. Water gets trapped within lid, like blocked in this mold. It causes steam, obviously. Also called the explosion. So I hold the mold up fairly high. I'm using two molds because even though this mold holds more, it overheats. This is producing a wad cutter bullet. Mold is made out of tool steel, and it only casts 2 at a time. There's a good shot. So that's a full wad cutter. Very accurate with my pistol. This bullet is semi-large cutter, also fairly accurate. Probably about 8 pounds, 7 pounds out of 10. And I'm going to keep the lead fairly high in this pot so that the gravity will feed it out quickly. So I'm going to fill the pot back up. Just ran up on a problem with this mold. This bolt that holds the sprue cutter down at the very end is tapped into aluminum. And those aluminum threads over the years have given way. So what it's causing is it's causing fins on the back of the bullets. So it just started. I think those bullets are okay. But I'm going to switch to another mold. This one may be able to be repaired, I don't know. One thing that I did do that seems to help, I use a mold dropout. It's in that spray can. And that just releases the bullets from the molds. What seems to work okay as well is two-cycle oil. I just put a bit on a cloth and on a Q-tip. And especially where the alignment pins go from left mold half to right mold half, put a little bit on the end of a Q-tip and daubed it in the pin and in the bushing, and that worked very good. And I put a little bit on the end of this rag and wiped it on the top of the sprue cutter, and with bullets still in the cavities, wiped it along the top. I don't know that that made a lot of difference. I wasn't getting any lead now, but what I understand is if you have any lead stick to the top between the sprue cutter and the mold, that'll cut it down. We'll see. I've got to get another mold. Now that this mold's cooled off, I can show you what's going on with it. Not sure if it can be repaired or not, but you see how loose this upper plate is. The thread stripped out, and it's in aluminum, so it may not be repairable. I don't know. Another semi-wad cutter, 38 caliber mold, and I haven't used it in many years. When I got through with it last time, I oiled it down. So I'm going to change that out on these mold handles. Clean the oil off. The oil will cause wrinkles in the bullet. So, get that off. another two cavity mold, so it's going to go slow, but it will go. I've had this mold for maybe 35 years. Eventually wear out, and I'll just put on another coat. I am using a composite, it's a UHMW, to cap the mold, just to cut down on wear. That's how much is left in the about 45 pounds. Maybe there's 15 pounds left.
So I'm about done. My shoulders can't take much more. I guess I've cast maybe 25 pounds. So these are the full wad cutters. Maybe 150, maybe 200. But that's from a double cavity mold. That's the semi wad cutter double cavity mold. Looks like maybe 100. They come out a lot slower, two at a time. And I may have got 100 of the semi-wad cutters out of the six cavity mold before it broke. So that's about it. The tips and the tricks are two cycle motor oil does seem to keep lead from sticking. The main tip is use a six cavity mold. These two cavity molds are terribly slow, almost at the why bother point. UHMW, that has been used for probably 30 years. No damage to the mold or the stick. And this is a Frankfurt Arsenal dropout. So that keeps the bullets from sticking in the cavities.